Hello, people of the whole world. Today, I will announce episode 0 of the series of a couple of videos, maybe 5, maybe 6, I'm not certain about that, of geopolitics, the European Union, the European continent, and my thoughts, and the thoughts of mine regarding those subjects, you know, understood? Well, there's gonna be a multifaceted and in-depth video regarding those subjects that I just mentioned. So, the first question I need to answer is, why do I speak English instead of Dutch? Because this series needs to be viewed by as many as people as possible. So I want to discuss several subjects, what I just mentioned, and the thoughts of mine regarding the European Union and how I want it to see it to be it administered. So I'm gonna not go in depth with it right now, because this is just episode 0, the introduction of the series of the couple of videos. So when you watch this video, it's April 8th, 2024. So I'm gonna rendering and upload it as soon as possible, as soon as I can, and rendering and add subtitles to it, and make it look perfect. But you guys will see it on April 8th, Monday, April 8th, if I'm not being wrong. So, to give you a few examples what I'm gonna discuss in the couple of series of this in the series. Well, I need you to know that I'm gonna discuss the Russo-Ukrainian war, what has caused the Russo-Ukrainian war, and what kind of things has led to the Russo-Ukrainian war. So, to give you concrete examples, the Euromaidan Revolution has caused that the Ukrainian president of that time has resigned his office. So, and during his resignment of his office, the American State Department has announced, and by a phone call, to give certain offices to certain politicians of the American imperialist war machine. You need to know that America has ever wanted war, as well as the European Union. The EU and America were always friends. Was ever since the foundation of the United States in 1776 and the European Union's foundation in 2007. So, since after World War II, Europe decided to become friends with the United States and close friend near friendship between the two states. And Europe wanted to copy the American imperialist war machine, and instead of making peace deals and negotiations regarding peace, the EU has done many, if you ask me, too many human rights violations. And that's a very, very bad thing, you know? Understood? Good. What I want to say is, what I'm going to discuss is the relationships between the European Union on one side and the American industrial war machinery on the other. And the Russo-Ukrainian war, European Union politics, the European geopolitics, and the European continent, and how does it work, and which countries are engaged in and located, etc., etc. So, if you're curious about what I'm gonna discuss about it during the series, please consider subscribing. Please consider giving me this video a thumbs up. Please consider leaving a comment if you want to know more, even if you have questions, please feel free to ask. Don't hesitate. Don't be ashamed to be a Dutch citizen or European citizen. Please ask me questions if you have any questions regarding European Union, European politics, geopolitics, and related to it, related to those subjects. So, yeah, I'm gonna close the video and wishes you a very pleasure day. Goodbye.